Well, first of all, I am the seventh female director with a feature film in Serbia. But the thing is that I don't think it's a small number regarding how much male directors also we have, and also how many women are interested in directing. I think that it is a natural thing how many, because like when we see how many women apply for the academy, also it's that number, something like that. So it's I think it's nothing very peculiar about the number. A couple of days ago I heard one guy after the film, he told me after watching the film that I have heart, a big heart. And I think that making this film for everybody in the crew and the actors, etc., etc., it was very important to have a heart and not to be brave. Because we really wanted to make the film very honestly and very openly, very directly, to speak about some problems. And when you want to make a film like that, it's very important that you be first honest towards yourself, and then to the theme, and of course to the characters. So I think that had to be made by people who could think about out of the box and who could really feel and not judge people immediately, but to try to understand. And I think that the whole crew was like that, and that is why we could make such a film. Well, the thing is that when I saw all these clips all over the internet of really young people who were filming themselves while they were bullying each other, or I saw a lot of sex tapes of really young girls, also slight violence in schools toward professors or other pupils, etc., etc. I really felt that something very strong is going on with the young generation, and I knew that I don't know anything about them, and I wanted to see what's going on. And to try to understand their problems. And for me it was very important to get to know them and to really feel their problems, because the problems of growing up in my generation and their generation is totally different. How we see intimacy is totally different. What do we think about self-promotion is completely different. Now it's getting more and more important, and how we try to find ourselves through the eyes of others is different. It's more important nowadays than when I was growing up. Also, I think that the society that we're now living in is really tabooizing emotions. And we have a generation that is growing up where there isn't a lot of emotions even shown in the media, and we're not speaking about them usually, and of course not we're not speaking very openly, very directly. And I think it's becoming like this because if we want to live in this civilized world we're living in, and we live in a world that we feel is totally free, and we can speak about everything. But the thing is that we have to know what's good and bad, and it has to be very precise. And when we put emotions also into that, it just becomes more complicated. And you cannot just define something is good or bad. You have all these shades of gray, and because of that, we're not speaking about emotions. And we have this whole generation that is growing up in such a way. So the thing is that I knew that I had to make big research so I could write the script and so I could direct, because I have to really understand what's going on. And I spoke with thousands of young people. We had 2 years of castings where I spoke with them about also on castings. about their experiences from their surroundings, etc. I went out where teenagers go out, and so I think I slowly got to know what's going on with the younger generation. And it's also a thing that from when I got the idea of making the film till when we had the world premiere on Rotterdam Film Festival, 6 years passed. So it was a really long period, and for every process we really left enough of time so we could really do it thoroughly and to really deeply to understand that. That is how I got into everything. When I wanted to make a clip, I first started from the social part and the cultural part, which were very interesting for me, but I didn't want to stay on that. I really wanted to make a very emotional, intimate film, and to make a love story. And I really think that Klip is a love story. What was interesting for me was what is going on with love. How does it emerge, and how is it expressed in such a cruel reality? So for me, I think when I started thinking about their relationship, I really felt that the younger generation have a problem with expressing their emotions, and usually they're expressing it very cruelly, and we cannot sometimes understand that there are a lot of emotions, that there is love over there, because we cannot recognize how they're telling that to us or among themselves. So that was a thing that was interesting for me. So for sure, I think it is, for me, it is a very passionate love story. And it is a story about how two young people who are afraid of expressing their emotions because they can be hurt. What is going on when they can hide behind sex? Because if they're saying it's just sex, then they're distancing themselves and they cannot be hurt. And how something that is the purest love of all, like teenage love, how it can be very complicated, and how it is expressed when, of course, somebody wants to do everything for love, and how it is when somebody wants to be loved and is fighting for that. When you have all these identities which are over there to be picked up while they're still trying to find there, and there are these very popular identities of alpha male, very machoistic guy on one hand, very dominant guy who doesn't express his emotions and is very cool. And on the other hand, have this overly sexualized girl who thinks that she has no taboos, and that she is so free. But on the other hand, she's not sure how to enjoy that freedom. And that was interesting how they are communicating. And for me, it is a love story, a really love story, and how two young people at one point start showing their emotions, and how it can be shown and it can be seen in such a cruel reality. I think there are some very cruel scenes, because I think that they're expressing their emotions in that way. And I think because it's they're very passionate. And also we have to have in mind, they're teenagers. They usually cannot rationalize their emotions. And there is a hurricane of emotions because they don't know, first of all, what they're thinking, what the other person is thinking, what the other person is thinking, or what are they thinking. And it is really a hurricane of emotions. And when the emotions are so intense, they just burst and usually are shown very cruelly. First of all, I had this feeling that the older generation in Serbia is a bit pathetic and that they're tired of fighting. And because of these big social turbulences, and I don't think that these social turbulences now are happening just in Serbia, we have it all over the world, that a lot of the older generation are really really hung up with their problems. And when you have a newer generation of their kids who are communicating in a totally different way, they're communicating through Facebook profile pictures. And the older generation first don't have so much energy to deal with some problems, and on the other hand, don't understand that their kids are communicating in some way. It's a totally new language for them. So I think because of that, there is a bigger generation gap today than before, because the communication is totally different. And I think that that is also why there is a problem how much the parents are involved and try to help the younger generation. How do they succeed in that because of that communication, which is totally different. Well, the thing is that I don't think it's a bad future. First of all, when I was starting to think about Klip, for me it was a film that is really about today, and it is very local, very authentic film. But I really wanted to make it a universal story, and also I didn't want to speak about today, but for me, a clip is more a film about the future. What can we expect about with the next generations of the kids that are the main characters in Klip? But also, I don't think that it is dark future. I just think that we have to try to understand what's going on with the younger generation and to try to help them. I don't think that they're bad. And for me, the very important thing is that not to make that the kids are the problem, but they have problems. And I think that if we try to understand, then there is no problem. But if we have a generation that is not communicating with the older generation and who don't have help from them, I think that could be a problem for the future. Well, the thing is, when we were making Klip, and I'm speaking about all the crew and all the actors, we didn't think about the reception afterwards. And it's the first film from like all of the crew, mostly all of the crew. And we just wanted to make the best film possible. So everything afterwards with the festivals and with the success, really we didn't think about that. So it's not that we didn't think that the film was good or it wouldn't have an audience or something like that. It was just we didn't think about these things. The main thing was to be honest to ourselves and to give as much as possible for the film, because we all believed in it. And we were so happy that the film was in Rotterdam. And everything just exploded after the TIGE Award and the Critics Award in Rotterdam, and it really went all over the festivals. And I think that, of course, that awards help the film, and I think it's very important for debutantes, first of all, because of the whole crew that was involved in the film, because usually films that are made by debutantes, it's a lot of passion that is involved in that, and it's like a low budget film, which are made that just on enthusiasm and made on how much the people are involved in that and how much they struggle for it. And for me, it was very important, all those awards, so that everybody in the crew knows that we did a good job and that somebody recognized that. But also what I think is that awards bring media attention. And with media attention, first of all, festivals are more able to see distributors, so there could be more and more people who can see the film. And also, like regular spectators can be informed about the film. And if they know about the film, they can maybe see the film. So I think that is why the awards are important. And for every debutant, the most important thing is that people see their films. It's why we all started this. So I think that is a good thing. I'm not sure what would be, because I didn't even think before what will be if we don't have or do have festivals. So. The movie. Well, I think that awards from such important festivals as Rotterdam Film Festival are really helping the film, because like I personally always I'm interested to see who is a winner of some big festival, especially Rotterdam, who has such a profiled view on films, and their policy of which films they are looking for is, I think, very precise. And in that, I think, case, just people and festivals know which is maybe some new directions in films, because I think that is what Rotterdam Film Festival is all about. And I think that, of course, it helps because of that. And well, for censorship, we really didn't have any problems, because I think that the film is very openly, very directly speaking about a lot of segments of lives, of the life of teenagers all over the world. And of course that people have strong reactions because it's shown so realistically, I think, in the film, because everybody wants to be presented better than they are. So people have strong reactions. But we only had one inconvenience, that in Russia, we didn't have the allowance of showing the films in cinema. In theater, we didn't have a theatrical distribution. It was shown in Moscow Film Festival. And I'm very sad because of that, because I think that the Russian public could very, very well relate to the film, because all the problems that are shown in Klip are the same, I think, in Russia, what's going on with their young generation. And also, they could very well, I think, relate to all the specifics. And I think that really not showing a film cannot solve a problem, because if they don't see this model of behavior in cinemas, they will see it for sure in their surrounding. And if a film is showing some problems, I think it can only emerge a discussion, and people can start raising questions. And if we all start raising questions and try to think and try to understand, maybe we can solve the problems. If we just don't look at them and don't show them. And I think that art is a way that we can see more reality than we can see in our lives, can be, and that we get more aware of the reality. I think that is the only way that we can start changing things. Well, I really wanted to make a film that the teenagers could see and also the parents. Because I think that a lot of teenagers don't have a chance of seeing these kind of films that which are very openly speaking about their problems in cinemas. And on the other hand, I think that a lot of parents don't see what's going on with their kids or in their surrounding, and or are not aware or don't want to see it. And when they see it in cinema, what I usually feel is that the younger generation, they're very happy because somebody's speaking about these things, and they really constantly are sending me like on Facebook messages to tell me how happy they are and to thank me because somebody is really speaking about what's going on. And on the other hand, a lot of parents are afraid and are very afraid, and they're thinking what's going on maybe with their children or somebody from their surrounding. And I think that for me, that is the biggest thing, really. I really wanted to make a film that will raise questions. So just for people to think about the film afterwards, for me, is the best thing. Well, the thing is that I think there is a good tendency now in Serbian cinema that there is a lot of really young authors that which are mainly debutants who are doing films very without no compromises and very passionately and really have a strong urge to tell some stories, and they have a need to make films. And I think that is a very good thing. There is really a lot of films that won a lot of also awards and festivals, which are also popular, like in Serbia or in regions, etc. Whether we're speaking about Skinning, Šišanje, Stevana Filipovića, or Tilva Roš, the director Nikola Žajić, Life and Death of a Poor Gang, also director Mladen Đorđević, etc. You have all these young authors who have totally different artistic views, and we are all totally different, and the films are totally different, and the way that we are thinking about the reality and about films is very different. But I think that there is a good thing that you have a lot of young authors who are like that, full of passion, making films. But I think that debutants cannot change the cinema in Serbia or wherever, and they can just bring a breath of fresh air. But you cannot rely on debutants to make a totally new cinema. And for that, I think it's very important that what's good that we have also directors of which are the middle generation who are now making their best films. And I think that is also very, very important for as so it is important that we have mainstream films which the audience adores and which will be like blockbusters, which are a good popular films for cinema, popcorn, etc. And on the other hand, art house. So I think that is a good thing that is going on now in Serbia. But I feel that still it is just an excess that a film is made. And when this thing develops, then we can speak about something that is systematically going better and better.